Now, starting with the vehicular characteristic study. As I said, vehicular characteristic study is all about the specifications of the vehicles. So, what are the specifications of the vehicles? One is weight of the vehicle, length of the vehicle, height of the vehicle, and width of the vehicle. So, these are the specifications of the vehicle. So, in the vehicular characteristic study, we will focus on these four factors of the vehicle. In this table, you can see the maximum permissible height, width, and length of the vehicle that is given as per IRC guidelines. The width is same for all the vehicles, that is 2.5 meter. The length is different for single deck vehicle, that is 3.8. And in case of double deck vehicle like double decker buses, that is restricted up to 4.75 meter. Now there are different kind of lengths available, as the truck with engine and unit combinations are different. So the lengths are categorized into four categories. As you can see, there is type 2, type 3 and other types also. So, the number of combination will be allowed to be not more than 2 units. Okay. So, just remember this point. So, this is the end. Now, coming into the point, braking characteristic study. In the braking characteristic study, will determine the braking efficiency of a car. Now, why this braking is important? The braking is important to maintain the space between two consecutive vehicles, and also to determine the stopping side distance, we need the braking characteristics. So, the braking characteristics will determine the braking efficiency by performing braking test. Okay. So, what is braking test then? It is the test to determine the braking efficiency. Now, how to determine the braking efficiency? So, you can find the braking efficiency by measure the longitudinal frictional resistance. And to measure the longitudinal frictional resistance, we need any two quantity out of these three quantities. Okay. So, these are the speed of car, braking duration and braking length. So, if we have the speed of the car and braking duration, then you can find the longitudinal frictional resistance. If we have the speed of the car and braking length, then also we can find the longitudinal frictional resistance. And it also goes for the braking length and braking duration. Okay. So, there are some formulas. Let's see. So, the value of the frictional resistance can be determined if we have the braking length and speed of the vehicle by using this formula. Mu is equals to V square by 2GL, where V is the speed of the car, G is the acceleration due to gravity, and L is the braking length. Similarly, if we have the speed and actual duration of the braking application, we can determine the braking, the frictional resistance or the mu value by using this formula Vyg into T naught, where T naught is the actual duration of brake application. And if we have the braking length and actual duration of brake application, then also we can determine the mu value by using this formula. Okay, so after calculating the mu value using any of these three formulas, we'll calculate the braking efficiency. Okay, so the formula of braking efficiency is the mu value we are getting from braking test divided by the maximum known mu value. Okay, now solve the following problem using the formulas that are already provided. Just remember one point that in this problem, the speed is given in kilometer per hour, but while putting the value in the formula, you have to convert it into meter per second. And the other point is here it is said that determine the average street resistance, that is same as frictional resistance. Okay, so now you hope you can solve the problem. So let's solve it.